Hi, I'm Peter J. Ray. Welcome to Adventures in History. Today's topic is Dearest Mother, Love Ruthie, Ruth Small Shaw Ray's Letters to Her Mother, 1945 to 1947, Part 10. Ford Hotel, Room 505, Toronto, Ontario, Canada, July 30th, 1945. Hello, Mama Honey. How are you, and do you miss me? And will you be glad to see Ruthie when she gets home? 'Cause it'll sure be wonderful to see you. As you'll notice, we're on the homeward stretch. It was perfect in Detroit, and I almost bawled to have to leave. I really like the United States, Mama, and Papa's sure kidding himself if he thinks I'm still a prairie chicken. Gee, if you were down here, I wouldn't care if I never saw a flat piece of Saskatchewan again. Oh, it'll really be nice to get home, but not on account of the prairies or winter coming up. Oh, look, dear, I'm checking the hat box home. There's a lot of junk in it, so don't analyze it. Better still, leave it tied up, because I'd like to open it myself. Put it away till I come home? I've put it through customs, so it'll be home soon. Well, we're here for a week, and in the meantime, go to Niagara Falls. I'll let you know as often as I can if there's anything you'd like to say to me. Write to 387 Arlington, Winnipeg, okay? Oh, gee, Mama dear, I had one wonderful time in Detroit. Jack got leave, so was in Detroit. I went to a few places. The Brass Rail, Hun's, Jade Room, Lalande Hotel, Dance, etc. I had a swell time. I think you were a little bit wrong on that fortune-telling business in Regina, remember? The girls had a room in a hotel and stayed there until 3 o'clock a.m. Much more sensible, but after all, the last night in the United States. Jack had his car, a beautiful blue coupe, so he drove us to the station. Beth can't kick as far as taxi fare goes. Marshall drove us to the train station in Saskatoon. Roger around Winnipeg and Jack in Detroit. Oh, did Marshall go through? Gee, the guys in customs weren't bad at all. As a matter of fact, very nice. He just looked in and didn't even bother opening one of mine. Then we got here. He was the Joe boy who carried my grips all the way and up through the station. Quite nice, an Air Force officer. Everyone really is swell, though. They've been so all the time. Hope to see a little bit of this place, although it seems small after Detroit. Right now it seems so wonderful, fast to relax after the tension of exams. No place to have to be or anything to have to remember. I slept last night 17 hours straight and needed it. I'm down to 120 pounds and Beth's 102, so we'll have to eat. Bye for now, and I love you. Please get the hat box. I'll write again. Love, Ruthie. Ford Hotel, Room 538, Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Undated. Dear Mommy, I guess, dear, that you'll think that every time I turn around I write to you, and so it seems. But so many times I wish that you were with me, and it is ages since I've heard how things are at home. We're leaving tomorrow for the Great Lakes, and I'll be in Winnipeg Thursday, so I hope I hear from you then. 387 Arlington Street. I guess I mentioned that I heard from Marion while at Fenny's. It was really swell. She's asked me to stay with her and made reservations at the Grand Beach for the weekend. I'm probably repeating. I did ask if it would be okay if she came home with me for a few days. It won't be like having visitors. Please let me know, dear, and also send my check on. Oh, Mama, this trip has definitely been worth the 2 years teaching. Gee, what's been packed into 2 months. It was really swell to have seen Pat. She's the same as ever, really good. Too bad you couldn't have had a good daughter like that. You made up for it in Bud. He's a good kid. Chris and Ken are really swell to me, and I saw Niagara Falls from every angle, I guess. They're very happy. She's glad she got married when she did, and realizes a few are disappointed that she didn't keep on in her nursing career. She hopes to have a baby girl about her birthday, February 14th. I hope she does. Davy's a good kid, but too much energy for her to handle at times. Chris isn't the energetic person she once was. I came back this noon, and just before I left, Davy brought me the mail, and I got a letter from Jack, the Marine. It was quite a nice surprise. I'd sent him a card from Auntie's when I got there Thursday. So you see, Mommy, why I wouldn't mind going back to Michigan? He's taking his officer's training course at the university. I guess Beth won't be in until tomorrow. She was supposed to reserve a room for me when she checked out, but when I came, no room. There was a lineup of about 10 people, and he turned them all away. I felt terrific. I wouldn't know where to go. So I used what's left of my personality or appeal or whatever it is, and 538 in a nice room. They can get rooms if they want to. He said, "Why do I always have to open my heart?" etc. Well, I guess my advice to Marion didn't go, 'cause she still hasn't been home. Believe me, I'll give her heck when I do see her. She hasn't been home since May. It'll be great to see her again, though. I don't think I have to worry about her getting married. She says she's having fun but realizes what she'd have to give up. Personally, I think it's one wonderful life. Oh, guess what, Mama? Of all the coincidences, you remember me mentioning my favorite deaf boy? There were a gang of them at the bowling alley, but one Alice mentioned she thought was nicer. Anyway, I roller skated with him several times. I ran into him here on the street Wednesday. He was so thrilled he laughed and could hardly move his fingers. It was nice. I guess it's so rare they meet anyone they can talk to. He kept repeating, "It's a small world." Beth went on. She said he looked silly laughing. It's really touching how lonesome they seem. It was a coincidence that he also happened to be at this time. He'll be back in Regina, though, after his holidays. I'm wondering how the exhibition is. Gee, after hearing the symphony, I think it would be the nicest thing in the world if Papa would only join the symphony again. I'm not kidding. Oh, do you think I should go to Minnedosa while I'm in Winnipeg? Is it far? Tell me. I'll have to go again, dear. I love you very much. Love, Ruthie. P.S. Don't you think Jack looks a lot like Bud used to? Note the snap taken with Des and Ted in their barrel sweaters. Maybe it's imagination. Canadian Pacific Great Lakes Steamships. Stateroom 7, Keewatin. August 9th, 1945. Dearest Mother, Mama, I can hardly believe that anything so nice can happen to me after all. Do I ever like this trip? Really, after such a perfect summer and now this, it's really quite an experience. Now I like traveling so much. I don't know how I'll ever stay put. It's swell. Yesterday I felt a little sick right after dinner, but everyone made such a fuss and put me in the middle of the boat, gave me gum, etc., that I just had to get better and did. It's really a lot of fun. We have a dance every night, and Beth and I have had quite a lot of attention. We got some sun today, as a matter of fact. One of the boys voted me the girl with the most beautiful legs on the ship. Don't let Papa read this or he'll think I'm corny. But it's a lot of fun. Two old maid school teachers having the time of their lives. I still have the old line that I'm a career girl and plan to teach for always, so one offered me $100 if I'm not married within 2 years. I know I'll make that easily and more. The meals are grand, though. We've had chicken, turkey, etc., everything. The boat is really nice and the water beautiful. It was quite interesting going through the Sioux Locks. I love you, dear, and I'll be seeing you about the 13th or the 14th, I guess. Bye, Ruthie. It's wonderful. Hi, buddy. 667 University Drive, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada. September 11th, 1945. Dearest Mommy. Well, how are you anyway? I guess I promised to write to you again and let you know the latest events. First, I'll admit my last letter must have been like something out of the Book of Gloom. In reality, Mom, I've spent the most gruesome days last week trying to reconcile myself to the fact that here I am, period, for better or worse, and there's probably some good reason. I can't see it now, but maybe in 20 years. So the last session at church finally clinched things, and I'm taking it as cheerfully as possible. It is nice to be happy again. I won't be very long, though, if MCP doesn't let up. I didn't mention in my last letter, didn't want to admit it, but Marshall took me to a show the first night I was back. I don't know how he knew I was. Anyway, it's on the rocks again, definitely. He's been over and phoned, too, and it always ends in an argument. So help me, Mom, I tried to be just friends. Oh, I won't bore you with it anymore, but sometimes I have to. Anyway, Saturday, Marion's cousin Bill and his boyfriend took us out. They're stationed at Prince Albert. Marshall phoned and was crabby as usual, too. The boys helped us put up our pennants. Quite an array. Really makes us feel as if we've been around. It was fun, though. I have a sweet bunch of kitties and really love them. I'm on boys' recess duty this week. Some fun and an awful lot of work. Is Saskatoon ever crowded, though? $100 rewards for rooms, and the houses are being built by the hundreds all over. They're trying to get it classified as a congested area. I'll have to dash to get some groceries. Write and tell me you love me. Bye. Love, Ruthie. P.S. Oh, one good thing. Marshall was over last night and went home mad. He thinks you are a wonderful woman and really have intelligence, character, personality, and appeal. Ahem. He says I have too, but I'm harder to get along with. Now, if you were 20, love, Ruthie. 667 University Drive, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada, September 13th, 1945. Dearest Mama, hi, dear, you're wonderful. No kidding, imagine being able to tell by that other letter of mine that I didn't feel as if life was the way it should be. As you know now, I'm a trying to reconcile myself to matters. I'm keeping, trying to, so... It was nice to hear from you, and Buddy's technique in developing is a little bit of all right. I'm really proud, too. I hated this choice of snaps, the one I'm in, but like myself and the scenery. Really good. Really nice to hear from you. As a matter of fact, I'll hint for a photographic coloring set, and we'll make a team of it, okay? Gee, I had a letter from one of the teachers in Michigan saying that our books are on exhibition there, and... Are your ears ringing? We're all talking about you. They think my illustrations simply adorable, and even though the books are being mauled, we're getting famous in the process. Swell, eh? American line, I presume. Thanks for re-add Dorothy's letter. It was really swell to hear from her. She said she intended to write to you and tell you what a sweet little girl I am, etc. Gee, Mom, it does seem a jip to be way up here and feeling as if you're missing so much. It's not as if they even appreciate things up here either. Oh, well. Yes, I told you I'd heard from Marshall. At supper tonight, I was telling Marion he was really getting good. Two whole nights silence, but the next minute he phoned again and spoiled it all. Wanted to know if I was still mad and what I was going to do tonight. I said... Bed at 8:30, so... Oh, yes, he's come to the conclusion that the reason we didn't work out was because we saw each other too often last Christmas. Smart kid, eh? We had Sunday school today and met the new minister, Reverend Jolly. Very nice. I had to spank a little girl yesterday. She was in Moffat's class last year, the one that cut off the chicken's head at home. Really a toughie. Love them all, though. Bye now. Hi, Bud and Pop. Love from Ruth. How were the snaps taken the day I left? Like the article in the paper? 667 University Drive, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada, September 16th, 1945. Dearest Mama, hi. No kidding, everything really is okay, swell, wonderful, at least at the moment. It's really terrific to discover that at one moment everything is nice, and then at the next, for no reason at all, to be down in the depths again. However, this happy mood has lasted a whole week. It's just that I don't know what to expect of myself next. I used to be sort of even, I thought. So, enough about my moods. It was so nice to get your letter and the snaps. I liked the one of us by the tree. It was really swell about Laurel. She's a pretty nice girl. Oh, I hope you don't get a million copies of the snap of us by the house for all the friends and relatives. Yes, Connie mentioned her mother being at our place, so suspected you'd be baking. I'll enclose some butter coupons of mine and some that Bill gave us. They're the ones with the beaver on. Servicemen's ration if they ask you, okay? I guess they should be in a booklet. Oh, mine are stripped, so we'll send you some this week when Mrs. Stewart sends some. Since we have our toaster, we use so much butter. Toast every time we turn around. I'm going to church in AYPA tonight, bowling tomorrow night in the Teachers League. Marshall bowls Wednesday in the Laundry League, so that's two nights that we can't possibly see each other, which is a good thing. I like him when I don't see him too often. He took me to the show and lunch and was very nice, cross my fingers. We met three of the deaf boys graduated as we were coming out, and one said he wished he had a girlfriend for the show. I couldn't say much as Marshall gets mad. So as Marion said, I shouldn't kick. Letters from a nice Marine and a guy whose pop owns three or four laundries driving up. It won't last. No, dear Marion and I are okay. She's swell as ever. I guess the big thing with Roger is really off. It's a secret. She really went back to the beach, but things weren't as good as she said. She had a letter from Arnie, the sailor down there, so things aren't too bad. It's the best thing in the world, I think. Roger is supposed to have got transferred to Port Arthur. Don't say anything in your letter to me. I finally got the trunk back yesterday from Beth's. Marshall said it was too big for the car, so I got the dime delivery. Marion washed, ironed, cleaned, and waxed yesterday. A wonderful woman. As Beth said, the guy that gets me will have to take Marion along. Good idea. So everything's okay. I'll let you know how things go hence. I'm gradually settling down, but every once in a while it really hits me that I'd like to be down in Michigan. Marshall says it's a sign of immaturity to be unsettled. I love you, Ruthie. 21A Myrtle Avenue, St. Augustine, Florida, United States of America, March 30th, 1947. Dearest Mother, it was really swell to get your letter yesterday, and I phoned and they're wiring to Chicago for your train reservation. It hardly seems possible that you'll be here so soon. The streamliners only leave Chicago for Florida every morning at 8:10 a.m. I should have told you before. It means that you'll have to stay overnight in Chicago. I'll write for reservations at the Morrison Hotel in Chicago for the night, the 7th. You'll leave Chicago at 8:10 a.m. the 8th and arrive here 8:43 a.m. Friday the 9th. I'll get your ticket and your reservation should be back from Chicago, and I'll send them to you and you'll get it by Monday, due. You could have picked up the reservation in Chicago yourself, but I thought you'd rather have it. Hope that it goes okay. You'll be coming on the streamliner, the South Wind, that goes through Indianapolis, so take a look at the city for me. See if I'd like to teach there. I've never gone on that train, so hope that it's as nice as the other two. It's rainy today, but hope it's nice when you come. Wade and I had a wiener roast last night in the sand dunes at the beach. He had Cokes packed in ice, wieners, buns, coleslaw, marshmallows, really thought of everything. We had to go in the old car, though, as they sold the one I learned to drive in yesterday. Sure sorry. Monday was the anniversary of meeting Wade. 6 months since we had our first date, and he sent me 8 red and 6 white roses. Really thoughtful of him. He told Marion he was sure I'd forgotten, so I made a cake and put happy anniversary on the top, and he got a big kick out of it. It was also the anniversary of my fifth year teaching. Hardly seems possible. Dale's encouraging me to go to summer school at the Cleveland University with her and stay on and get my degree, but I haven't enough money. We'll write again and send the ticket. Be seeing you. Love, Ruthie. To be continued. Well, that concludes today's presentation. Dearest Mother, love, Ruthie. Ruth Smallshaw Ray's Letters to Her Mother, 1945 to 1947, Part 10. Good luck to you with your efforts in family history if this interests you. Finding, preserving, and sharing old letters, diaries, and photographs, and interviewing elderly relatives while they're alive. You might consider liking and subscribing. You also might consider checking out our website, Adventures in History with Peter J. Ray at peterjray.com. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. God bless you. Take care. And I'll see you next time.